Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato. On today's Everything Music, it's What Makes This Song Great, episode 81. The artist is Stevie Wonder and the song is Superstition, coming up next. Superstition was released on October 24th, 1972. The song was actually written for Jeff Beck, and they were jamming together, and Jeff was actually playing the opening drum beat while Stevie was jamming, improvising over it, and they came up with the riff. There's actually a version of Superstition on this record. That album was actually going to be released first, but it ended up coming out a few months after this because they thought that this was going to be a really big hit for Stevie, so he recorded it himself. Most of the music was played by Stevie. He played the drums, he played the Moog bass, he played the clavinet parts on a Hohner clavinet, and we had the addition of Trevor Lawrence on the saxophone and Steve Maddeo on the trumpet. Let's take a listen to the beginning of the song. Love it. So we have a bunch of clavinet parts here, along with a Moog keyboard bass. I'm gonna start soloing that. All different types of EQs. Amazing. Have this one with the echo that comes in. Let me play that from the beginning. All this is adding to the groove. And here's the bass. Let's check out the drums soloed. One of my favorite things on this track is right in the beginning, you can hear Stevie talking to the horn players. Listen. Play soft, play soft. Make it sound better. And you can hear him singing. Stevie's singing the figure to him. After the long intro, the vocals enter. Very superstitious. I'm gonna solo him here.
Writings on the wall. Very superstitious. Letters about to fall.
What a great vocal performance.
13 months old, baby.
And then we have this horn part that enters here, which is really amazing. To me, this is, besides the vocal, this really makes the song. You know what's really great about this is that there's so much about the groove that is really incredible. So many of these overlapping rhythms in the clav parts. That you think that there's no room for those horns to even play a counter rhythm to that. But then, chorus
that you don't understand, and you suffer.
Let's talk about the chorus here. Let me play it.
When you believe in things that you don't understand, and you suffer.
Let's solo that drum fill. Let's talk about the chord progression of the chorus. It's really great. So it goes B flat 7, B7 flat 5, B flat 7, A7 flat 5, A flat 11, or E flat minor over A flat, and then B flat 7 altered, and then it goes back into the riff. E flat minor pentatonic. Let me solo the horns on the riff just before the chorus and then through the chorus tag. Check it out. Awesome. It's a really great melody in the chorus too. Let's check it out. He's hitting all those common tones in the first couple chords, right? Because you retain that F on the first three chords. And then he goes down to the E-flat on the A7 flat 5. And then it's a sharp 5 on the B-flat 7 altered. Really, really strong melody. The second verse starts the same as the first, but there's some great changes to the melody that happens. Let's check it out. It's amazing that you hear this keyboard bass and it sounds like a real bass. I love this line right here. Oh. What's especially good about that is that it leads you right into that second half of the verse where the horns change up.
Keep me a daydream.
Oh, that's such good singing. Let's listen from there.
Keep me a daydream. Keep me going strong.
I wanted to point out another thing that happens. This is where the bass line changes from the Moog bass here that Stevie's playing. So here's this second half of the verse.
Keep me.
And it goes right along with the horns. Check it out. Woo!
Sad is the song. You believe in things.
Awesome. Oh! Another killer fill, different fill here at the end of this chorus. Check it out. And here's a drum fill. I love how he does this drum fill over the horn riff there. Bridge. Let's check out that scream that happens right there. Listen. And there's a really great bass lick that happens on the Moog. That's totally weird, but great, right? Listen again. You never notice. It sounds like a real bass.
Mm.
Wow. And then you put that in with the bass and drums together. Listen. I really love the pocket of the song, meaning the groove in this next section, the way all the instruments work together. Check it out. That the echoey clav is killer. I mean, really just laying it down. That open hi-hat. And then those horns are back in. Right there, what he does rhythmically in the vocal is great. It's killer. It's just all... these are just all ad-libs, but they're so in the pocket. It's so well sung. It's amazing. Back to the chorus. He keeps riffing on the melody. And you have the really cool bass riff again there. Listen to that context. That you don't understand in yourself. Just a killer drum fill there. Listen to the drums. That you don't understand in yourself. Supposed to shine it the way. So good. Oh man. Just so right in the pocket. The amazing thing about this, once again, I always harp on this. I hope you don't get sick of it, but this is in the early 70s. There's nothing to fix the groove. It's just grooves. It's real. It speeds up and slows down. Today, if they recorded that, everything would be quantized. You know, all the keyboard parts, all the drums. But this is just so in the pocket. It's just Stevie's feel is ridiculously good. From here out, the song fades on this riff. The horns change a little bit. Oh, so good. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're interested in the Beato book or t-shirts, coffee mugs, anything to support the channel, that's how I make a living. Go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. Follow me on Instagram at rickbeato1. Check out the new Beato ear training method. Go to beatoeartraining.com and watch the introduction video. And if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching. Oh,